Hi everyone, my name is Tetet. I want to discuss about the interlaced ID architecture at the Coda system. As a first question, the root cause for the substantial plan deviation in the project state one and the fully even deviation in the project state two. I found 4 points for the issue. I found 4 points for the root cause. Firstly, the requirements are not properly documented. There were several different versions of the document, but none of them were fully quantified to make a final recommendation. Secondly, the project management team was a lack of focus in the enterprise architecture. They needed to understand about the functionality, data structure, and architecture as well. The new FSCD system included the additional features that did not exist in the current system. And also, these additional functions were just roughly estimated and not investigated in details. And also, the system did not cover for the existing requirements in other areas. That's why, consequently, the cross-platform integration is needed to interface with the existing system. Then the data exchange with the external business partners were needed, but there is no suitable middleware solution was implemented yet. Lastly, there is a system over estimation. That's why they did not think about the quality assurance and the error detection plan as well. Move to the next question. The project can be completed successfully. I can say yes, but with the exceeded budget and delay timeline. And also, the project management team need to separate the projects priorities and tasks, and then they need to have the standards and priorities for the implementation. They need to have the packet and recovery plan when they encounter the unexpected issue or problems. For the question number three, how can this Coalition 2008 project be improved? I found five key points to improve the project. First point is to understand about the architecture, and the second point is to have the project priorities and tasks, and then third point is the clear understanding of roles and responsibility between the internet team and the software or hardware vendors. And then the fourth point is that the project management team should have the monitoring system to track the project status and update. And then the last point is that they need to have the testing and the implementation plans details. For the question number four, the architectural documentation. There are some common things to be added in the proper architecture documentation. The first thing is the project goals. The second thing is the requirement specification. Need to identify what are the user needs, what are the business needs, and then what are the functionalities. And the third thing, the documentation should have the system architecture, application architecture, and the data architecture as well. And also, project documentation need to define the operational models and the project metrics, and they should include the documentation should include the deployment and implementation plan, packet and recovery plan. In the case for the Coda system, I think they need to have the subsystems and interface detail, and then the testing methodology. That's all for my discussion. Thank you.